When you launch the Avid Media Composer software, a Select Project window will eventually appear. Inside the Select Project window, you will see a list of projects. If the Avid software has never been used before, you won't see any projects listed. At the top of the window, you will see a preset location for your Avid projects. Below that, you will see a User Profile pull-down menu. For the purposes of this online training, I recommend that you go ahead and create your own unique user profile. Press OK when you're done typing your name. This user profile will contain various settings and preferences within Avid Media Composer that are unique to yourself. Don't worry, we'll cover the specifics of some of the important preferences in a later lesson. Okay, with that being said, the folder location for your Avid project depends on these three choices. Choosing Private will only display projects for your Mac or Windows user account. Now, I'm referring to the actual account you use to log into your computer and not your user profile. So, by choosing the private option, if other individuals log on to the same machine with a different user account, they will not be able to see your project. Now, if everyone is using the same account when logging into the computer, there's not much difference between clicking on this private option versus shared. So, with that being said, choosing the shared option will place your Avid project in a common folder that all account holders will be able to access. Keep in mind that the private option and the shared option are fixed locations that are located on the system drive. These locations cannot be changed. Okay, so finally, choosing the external option will allow you to choose your own location for an Avid project. In doing so, it's critical that you remember where you've stored your project, so you can reopen it again. So in this example, I'll choose the desktop as the location for my project. Now go ahead and click on the New Project button. A new project dialog box will appear. Now go ahead and name your project. In this example, use the name Extreme Sports. Within this dialog box, it's important to choose the video format that you will be working with. If you are dealing with mixed formats, choose the format that matches the majority of your content. For the purposes of this online training, leave the format set to 30i and the aspect ratio set to 16:9. Then press the OK button. For demonstration purposes, you can now see that I have a project called Extreme Sports that has been saved to the desktop. So now, when you select your project and press the OK button, you will have a fresh interface with an Avid Media Composer. And don't forget, GeniusDV also offers classroom and flat rate on-site Avid Media Composer training.